Your mailboxes are so handy. I wish we did it like this.
Hi, American here again. We've switched from this kind of mailbox that's below me and above me and to my left to the one behind you because these ones pictured on my page only hold like a business sized envelope, and sometimes you get bigger things in the mail and like newspapers and such. And those hooks down if you look down bottom left, those hooks are for like newspapers and stuff. But sometimes you don't have those, and they just shove everything in this in the one below me, which is business envelope sized. It's really not big enough. So we switched to the one that's behind your picture. But still, some things, especially if it says do not bend, they'll bend it and put it in there. And we still do have to go to the post office for stamps and stuff.
Replace every vowel in your name with oob. Please, it makes me laugh so hard every time.
I would be Jubin Woobth Oobin Oob-N. Unholy Shade would be Oobin Hooblube Shoobdoob. Godless Engineer would be Goobdaloobs Oobin Goob Noobuber. And Shannon Q would be Shoobin Noobin Q. Thank you. I've been Jubin Woobith Oobin Oob N.
Right, love. Do you want to come down to the pub for a pint? Please say it.
Are you okay, hon? Do you want to go down to the bar for a drink? And, or, is everything okay? Do you want to go get a glass of wine somewhere?
Much does it cost if you just need to go to the doctor's for a quick appointment about?
Okay, so I have insurance. I have pretty good insurance from my husband's employer. So my regular doctor visits are zero, and a specialist is $20. That's a copay. For prescriptions, if I get sick, if I can find a generic, it's zero. And if it's not generic, it's only a percentage of the sticker price, like $20, $30, up to $50, depending on what is needed. I'm trying to talk too fast. So, if you don't
Excuse
have
me a second.
insurance, your doctor's visits are going to be like $50 to $200, $300 for a specialist. Same thing for prescriptions. If you can find a discount card somewhere, it's $50 or so for a bottle of penicillin. But my mom, with Medicare, was just trying to pay $400 for half a month of Xarelto.
Name a show that you remember that you're pretty sure nobody else remembers.
I was very excited when this came out. I remember specifically sitting down and watching it because that's before everybody had DVRs. And they didn't even air the whole series, the whole first series on TV. You had to go online and find it later through whatever channel they had, whatever channel initially had it on their website. It was called Wonder Falls, and I thought it was so cool because she was in Niagara Falls and she worked in a souvenir shop, and the little tchotchkes and souvenirs came to life and talked to her and told her to go help people, to go, this customer would come in and if she would be, you know, she would need help in something, and this like turtle would turn around and be like, you have to go help her, she needs help with blah blah blah. And I thought it was really innovative and cool, and it didn't fare well, and I liked it.
So this time I have a question about the school buses and the system, how it works.
Hi, American here again. School buses. So we have a bus stop. Dog is barking. We have a bus stop right down at the corner of our block, about six houses down. And that's for the high school. And all the kids from this like 5 block radius all meet there. For middle school, we are walking distance to the middle school, even though it's about a 20-minute walk. But yeah, the same thing for middle schools and elementary. But the littlest kids, they get dropped off and picked up in front of their houses, just like out in the country areas where it's more rural. Like, my sister's kids, they live out in the country, and they would get picked up and dropped off right in front of their house all through high school.
I was an atheist. I didn't want to hear anything about God, and I did not want to believe.
Now, I don't know how to do this without saying the no true Scotsman fallacy. Somebody please help me do this without saying the no true Scotsman fallacy. Because I don't believe for one second you were an atheist. There's a difference between actively not believing and just passively being a non-believer that knows nothing about the faith. And I'm not trying to gatekeep atheism. I'm really not. But there is a difference here. If God wants to talk to me, he can talk to me whenever he wants. He doesn't have to wait for me. I was a believer for over 25 years. He doesn't need permission. Seriously. What are you on here?
Please explain to me what a block is. Like, you hear people say, oh, it's...
All right, so say you grew up in this city. And say you grew up right here on 80th Street. So your block where you grew up would be this area. All right? And then from Niagara Falls Boulevard down to this intersection is one block, and then down to the next intersection at the bottom right here is another block. Same thing for going from left to right. That's another block. So this is a very easy map because it's all in squares and in rectangles, but some have curly whirlies, you know, and some have curves, and this is just a straightforward up and down left and right map. Okay, so it's just an increment of area that is divided by side streets or a main thoroughfare. Like, this is a main thoroughfare.
Glad I triggered you, and you guys keep on up with the hate. It's a shame that that's how you resolve everything.
Does this look like a basement to you? What kind of person goes around and is glad they triggered someone? Could it be a hateful kind of person? It's because of Trump that I no longer speak to most of my extended family. Or rather, they no longer speak to me. Because I'm a libtard. That sounds a little hateful.
Y'all really out here saying God isn't real, and you hate him.
Y'all, as in more than one? Can you name more than one person you've heard say that? Because I've never even heard one person say that who wasn't building a straw man saying that people were saying that in the first place. In other words, the only people I ever hear saying that are Christians saying that atheists are saying that. But I've never heard an atheist say that. I've heard atheists always say, we don't say that. Why do you keep saying we say that? And then the Christians say, oh, well, I heard people say that. So can you just name one person that has legitimately ever said that?
Happy day, happy Daisy. Night, happy eating,
Daisy.
Happy tight, whack your tail, run and hide, give the kids a pony
She's
ride.
She's behind
happy
you again.
Dog, pollywog,
don't
fetch
look.
A stick, chase a frog, eat your food, don't be rude, always smile. Deedle-dee, deedle-dum, fiddle-faddle-fodle-bum, ricky-tick, rocky-tock, snicker-doodle,
bobby-sock,
ding-a-ling, birdie-sing, tickle-tockle, tamarink, mergle, skipper, rambling, always smile.
I know. It's so hard being a dog.
Piper, say please.
Oh, okay, good girl.
Okay, stitch this with your best why the fuck did I retain every single word to this.
Shit. Here we go. I pledge allegiance to the Bible, God's holy word. I will make it a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. I will hide its words in my heart so I may not sin against God. Anybody else do this? Yeah. First grade through 9th or 10th. And then I was a leader. And then after a little while, I was a leader again. Do you know how old the Puggles are? Any idea? 3 years old. Making a memorize.
So why are you wearing a cross necklace when you are not living as a Christian?
Ignorant Christian, party of one. Now seating, ignorant Christian, party of one. Your table is ready. On today's menu is the definition between hijab, niqab, and burqa. A hijab covers the hair, a niqab covers the whole face except the eye holes, and a burqa covers the whole body. Learn something. Oh, and you might want to check this out. But every woman that prayeth or prophesieth with her head uncovered dishonoreth her head. From Corinthians. That's the New Testament. Today's dessert selections will be gatekeeping. Just gatekeeping. It's served with a giant gold cross on top of the ice cream.
Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Catch it.
Oh, no. Sit down. Have a seat.
What?
Yeah, just trust me. Sit down. Okay, I'm sitting down. Cool. Yeah, we're not going to do that one anymore, me.
And why not?
Because it's a racist song.
It's...
No, it's not. Yeah, that song is literally associated with slave trade in America. Like,
eeny, meeny, miny, moe? Catch a tiger by the toe?
Yeah, the word was not always tiger.
Well, if the word wasn't tiger, then...
You got it.
Yeah, but that's the only one, though, right? That's the only one, right?
We don't need to escalate. You see, war is not the answer. For only love can conquer hate. You know we've got to find a way to bring some love.
Two, God is evil, the God of the Bible. So here we are, human.
Do you believe in the four omni-god, all-powerful, everywhere at once, all-knowing, and omnibenevolent? Because if you do, how can that four omni-god sit by and watch bad things happen? If he's everywhere at once, and he's all-powerful, and he's all-knowing, he knows all the bad things are going to happen, but he doesn't stop them. So, does he care not to stop them? Does he like watching the bad things happen? Is he incapable of stopping them? Until you fix the problem of evil, you got nothing.
Tell me you have a chronic illness without actually telling me you have a chronic illness.
Say his name correctly. Trump.
You couldn't even say Clinton correctly. Please. His real name should be Drumpf. D-R-U-M-P-F. That was his grandfather's name when he immigrated here. Why is Trump so against immigration? His grandparents were immigrants. He married immigrants. Like, God, what? And why do you guys still have a hard-on for this guy? I know I saw the golden calf at the CPAC, but Jesus Christ. Speaking of that, Trump's grandmother's name was Elizabeth Christ. He should have kept that last name. He would have gotten a little bit further with the evangelicals. Just saying.
Republicans have failed to convict a president who incited a deadly insurrection against the United States government. Their betrayal will be remembered. But there are at least four other ways to hold Trump accountable. First, forbid him from ever holding office again under Section 3 of the 14th Amendment, which bars anyone from office who has been found to have, quote, engaged in insurrection or rebellion against the Constitution. That finding can be made by a simple majority of both houses. Second, prosecute him under Title 18, U.S. Code 2383, which makes it a federal crime to incite insurrection against the United States, punishable by up to 10 years in prison. Third, prosecute him for interfering in Georgia's election results. Georgia has already begun that investigation. Fourth, strip him of all perks offered to ex-presidents, including a taxpayer-funded $200,000 a year pension and $1 million travel allowance. Again, it takes only a majority of Congress to do this. He must be held accountable.